Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Hope by the grace of Almighty Allah that you all are fine. As this is class 10th and we were in touch with the chapter in civics that was political parties, and we have already finished that with the chapter in the last lecture. I have taken one more unit in class 10th of civics, that is outcomes of democracy. And here, inshallah, first of all, we will be trying to know what do you mean by democracy, and accordingly, we will go through its features. Got it, Shabash? So, first, we will talk about what do you mean by democracy. Samjhaya, Shabash? So, jo democracy hai, ye kaha jata hai, that it's a combination of two Greek words. Democracy is a combination of, Shabash, two Greek words. That is, Shabash, demo and kratos. Demo and Kratos. Democracy is a combination of how many words? Two Greek words. Demo and Kratos, which means people's rule. Which means people's rule. So in short, you can say, if we see its literal meaning, Shabash, what is that? That is rule by people. There you can say people's rule. Samjhaya, Shabash. In broad sense, we will see what you mean by democracy. So remember this very point. There is no clear-cut definition. There is no universal definition for democracy. Democracy ke liye koi universal definition nahi hai. Why is it so? Because jo democracy term hai, because jo term democracy, it varies from country to country. Shabash, it varies from country to country. The term democracy varies from country to country, and not only country to country, but it also varies from ideological perspective to perspective. Got it? Well, if anybody will tell you what is the clear-cut definition of democracy, I already said to you that there is no clear-cut definition, there is no common definition, there is no universal definition for what? For democracy, because the word democracy varies from country to country, because the term democracy varies from country to country, and it also varies from ideological perspective to perspective. Samjhaya? Now some scholars have defined this very term in their own way. Samjhaya? So both of the scholars this term ko shabash apne andaaz mein define kiya hai. You might have heard the name, agar aapne kabhi naam suna hoga, that was Abraham Lincoln. Shabash? Abraham Lincoln, iske baare mein aapne khud bahut kuch suna hoga. Abraham Lincoln, so how he defined democracy, Shabash? He said it's a government of the people. Wahi kaha, it's a government of the people, for the people, and by the people. He said it's a government of the people, by the people, and for the people. Who said it? This is the famous definition as has been given by Abraham Lincoln. This is OF of here, this is F word for here, and this is BY by here. Lekin agar hum aaj dekhenge to aaj hum isko is andaaz mein lenge, because the present type of democracy is not taking care of everybody's rights. Ye baat aap gaur se suniye. Jo aaj kisam kal ki jo ye democracy hai, it is not taking care of everybody's rights. It is not taking care of the rights of the minors. It is not taking care of the rights of the SCs and STs. Have you got my point? So point of saying here, this aaj hum isko ye keh sakte hain, it's a government of the people, O double F. It's a government of the people, for the people. This is a for, we can say F here for the people. It never reaches the people. Got it? This is by the people. We can say B Y E by. One is there, Shabash, being elected. Ek baar jab ye elected hote hain, ek baar jab ye vote matlab jeete hain ya kya karte hain, Shabash, to then they are never taking care of the people. Then they are never visiting those very people, matlab from whom they got their votes, from whom they got elected. Samjhaya? So what I mean to say, jo kiski definition hai, democracy ki jo definition hai Abraham Lincoln ki, no doubt it is a good definition that has been given by Abraham Lincoln. But remember this very point too, I said you that this very definition is not working in the present context, because the present type of democracy is not taking care of everybody's rights. Good, this is Abraham Lincoln. Agar hum definition lenge Shelley ki, agar aapne naam suna hoga Shelley, S-H-E-L-L-E-Y. So how Shelley defines democracy, Shabash? He said, usne kaha jo democracy is a form of government in which everybody has a share. To isne bola, in which everybody has a share. In which everybody has a share. What do you mean by this? Means in which everybody will get his rights. In which there will be justice, in which there will be equality. Samjhaya? To ye kisne kaha? Shelley defined democracy in which everybody has a share. So it's a form of government in which everybody has a share, means in which everybody will get his rights, in which there is equal protection of law, in which there is equality and all that. Got it? So it was defined by Shelley. Samjhe? And remember one more point, there is one more scholar whose name is Satori. Uska naam tha Satori. You can write it down, Shabash. There is a scholar whose name is Satori. S-A-T-O-R-I. S-A-T-O-R-I. One of the scholars, one of the greatest scholars, whose name is Satori. And it is said that he calls this world as world of democratic confusion. He said this world is world of democratic confusion. Dikha, Shabash, this world is world of democratic confusion. In nutshell, iske kehne ka matlab ye hai, jo democracy hai, it has no clear cut definition. It means different to different people. It means different to different countries. It means different to different ideologies. Have you got my point? So, kehne ka matlab hai, jo Satori isne kya kaha? It's the world of, he calls this world as world of democratic confusion. Have you got my point? Aur agar hum nutshell mein dekhenge to democracy ab kya hai, Shabash? You can write it down. Democracy is a political form of government, Shabash. So, democracy is a political form of government in which governing power, remember, in which governing power is derived from the people by consensus. Remember, in which democratic, in which governing power is derived from whom? From the people by consensus. After that, we know that there is consensus democracy, there is classical democracy, there is modern democracy, there is representative democracy. I can't discuss it here. So point of saying is that democracy is a political form of government in which governing power is derived from whom? From the people by consensus, by direct referendum, There is recall, there is referendum, I can't discuss it here. So by consensus or by direct referendum or by means of elected representatives of the people. Or by means of, Shabash, elected representatives of the people. Jisko bolte hain representative democracy. Jisko bolte hain kya? Representative democracy means the government represented by whom? By people. What my point? So democracy ka maane kya hai, Shabash? So democracy is a political form of government in which governing power is derived from the people by consensus, by direct referendum, and remember, by means of elected representatives of the people, jisko bolte hain, Shabash, representative democracy. Aur democracy mein aapko ye bhi baat yaad rakhni hai, kaha jata hai, in democracy requires that all citizens have an equal opportunity to express their opinion. Samjha? Means har kisi citizen ko ye mauka milna chahiye that he will express his own opinion, that he will express his. So in democracy, everybody is having his right of, Shabash, freedom of speech and expression, isn't it, Shabash? And one more point of democracy, it is said that in democracy, it is the people who holds autonomous power over legislators and government. So please note it down. In democracy, Shabash, it is the people who holds autonomous power over legislators and government. So remember, I mean to say in easy words, democracy mein sara power kinke haath mein hota hai? Logon ke haath mein hota hai. Isliye maine bola, in democracy, it is the people who holds autonomous power over legislators and legislators mean those who make laws and government. So government mein Shabash zyada role kinka hota hai? People ka hota hai aur legislators pe bhi zyada role powerful role kinka hota hai? People ka hota hai. This is all about the meaning of democracy. Inshallah, in the next lecture I'll be discussing democracy, main features of democracy, ya democracy as best form of government. Thank you.